There is a certain mythic quality to nearly all of Cormac McCarthy's novels. His stories are enveloped in a prose that almost falls into poetry and envelop the reader in deeply human experiences. More so than in his other works, The Road does this to an extent that may frighten some due to its bordering nihilism, and yet enthrall others. The story is that of a man and his son who travel across a post-apocalyptic America in search of the coast. What they will find there remains ambiguous throughout the novel, and the journey they take is a treacherous one. Bandits often parade the streets, living off the fear of others in a society that has been lost many years prior. And yet, all throughout this, a faint glimmer of hope remains, not just for the boy and his father, but for the human condition itself. The first thing anyone notices about The Road is its utterly morbid imagery, which is perfectly fitting for a world in that condition. He walked out in the gray light and stood, and he saw for a brief moment the absolute truth of the world. The cold, relentless circling of the intestate earth, darkness implacable, the blind dogs of the sun in their running, the crushing black vacuum of the universe, and somewhere two hunted animals trembling like ground foxes in their cover. Borrowed time and borrowed world and borrowed eyes to sorrow it. This single description should be enough to put into context just the natural dangers of the world. But in order to battle this impending danger, the father and his son use three methods of hope in order to guide them. The first is the coast, which provides a real, sensible feel of hope that they can achieve, which is something all humans need in order to find a place in the world. The coast is also often described as a place where anything can happen, like an ultimate destination. This brings the novel down to a more relatable level because of the physical motivation that we all seek in life. The second one is more complex than the coast. Throughout the novel, the man often mentions the carrying of a fire that him and his son must maintain in order to survive. This could be seen as an internal drive of hope, one that resembles the undying human spirit and the quest to survive. The father tells his son how only a few people in the world still carry it, which would be fitting, as internal hope doesn't seem to have any sort of place in a world that is so cruel and violent. The third and final hope comes strictly from the father, his dead wife. He will dream about her constantly throughout the novel, asking her to guide him. Since this is something that can only be attributed to the man, we can infer that it is the hope of reconnecting with past lives. Since the man's son was born into this post-apocalyptic world, and therefore has no memory of his mother, he also has no memory of this past world where everything seemed to be perfect, whereas the man, his wife is a fragment of the past, and of a world he so longs for. It's also fitting that the novel should be called The Road, because the journey the man and his son take quite figuratively resembles the road we people take in our lives. Although the world depicted in McCarthy's novel may seem detached from ours, it really isn't so much so. Our sense of morality directly parallels the man's. He tells his son of stories about good people versus bad people, but how can someone have such a black and white morality in a world where the air is literally grayed by the falling ash? And throughout our lives, we will be reduced to using this type of morality too, even though it might not make any sense in a world with so many people and so many ideologies. We'll cheer on soldiers fighting against those who oppress our own freedoms, just as the man will easily kill anyone who threatens him or his son in the novel. But if we turn this sense of morality on its head and place ourselves into the perspectives of our enemies, who might just be scared that we are infringing upon their freedoms, as we are scared of them doing to us, then it may be possible to seek a better understanding of this world. Similar to how we should be skeptical towards the subjective characters in the novel, we should be skeptical towards our own worldly events. To put it all into context, it's not very fitting that the man or we use such moralities in our respective worlds. It's almost like using some sort of moral map or guideline that is incomprehensible and tattered, similar to the map that the man and his son used to get to the coast. Perhaps McCarthy is trying to argue that life and the moral decisions we will have to face are as complex as the scale patterns of the brook trout he mentioned in the final paragraph of the book, which he so rightfully alludes to as maps and mazes of the world in its becoming, and in whose deep glens lived all things older than man, and which hummed of mystery. But despite this confusion that we face in life, we will always have a light to guide us, similar to the coast, to the fire, and to the wife. We will always have something to strive for, and to help us define our own personal beings. Hope.